What's going on YouTube? Sam here with TKO Gaming, bringing you guys a video on how you can maximize your light to the max level of Destiny 2 right now, which is 350 light. And I'm sure this will work beyond that because this is what everybody is doing. For those of you wondering, like, hey, I got a character, I put in hours every single day, how come I can't get my level up? Well, this video is going to tell you exactly what the best of the best Destiny players are doing, and really what they're doing is grinding, but we're going to tell you exactly what they're doing. So before we get into the video, we're giving away a Confluence of Light emblem code. All you have to do is like this video and comment down below what your light level is in Destiny 2 right now. That's all you have to do. Follow that by hashtag Destiny 2, and let's get into this video. One more thing I do want to mention, guys, is that any info that I don't talk about in terms of powering or leveling up fast in Destiny 2, well, that's because I have two other videos that I made on how to rank up super fast in Destiny 2, along with loot cave videos and all that. So let's get into exactly what people are doing. So essentially, you make your first character in Destiny 2 and you start ranking up. You get to light level 265, obviously, after you finish the campaign. So whatever rank you are when you finish the campaign, you'll automatically get boosted to level 20. Then your power level starts coming into play, and going around the EDZ, going doing the loot caves that I came up with. You guys can go and check those videos out on my channel, and then you guys can get to light level 265 super easy. Now, when you get to 265 light, that's when you start to slow down, and that is when powerful engrams, luminous engrams, and exotic engrams come into play. So I made multiple videos on how you can get those and the fastest way to get those. But if you guys don't know, you guys can do flashpoints. Essentially what it is one random planet will have public events. You have to go finish that off. Well, that's what it was this week. You have to do a bunch of public events on a certain planet. Once it's all done, you'll go and collect your luminous engram, your powerful gear from Cade. And I got an exotic from it as well. I believe you get an exotic and a legendary. That's how powerful it is. I don't think it's guaranteed, but I think most people I know got that. Next thing you can do is a nightfall. You have Zavala, who gives you the nightfall powerful bounty or whatever. It's a milestone. You go and get the nightfall done. You have a chance at an exotic in there. Then you can meet Zavala and get whatever he has to give, which is another powerful. And those luminous and powerful gear, they scale. They'll scale at your level. No matter what level you are, they'll scale up. Now, this is a very important topic because a lot of people need to know that all these people that are like 300, 325, and 350, what they're doing is they're making multiple characters, and they're making the same exact character. So if you have a warlock, you make two other warlocks, so you have three total. And they do the grind again after they get level 20. After finishing the campaign, they just simply transfer their gear over to their next character. And what they'll do is they'll start doing the same exact thing. So you'll go do the exotic Stern quest, or you'll go do the exotic whatever quest. It doesn't matter whatever you do, but because you're a higher light level now, that's when you'll get it. So then you get another exotic and you're like, why would they get multiple exotics? Well, then their other light level, power level, they can then infuse that into legendary gear, because as you guys know, exotic weapons have that mod on it that give it the 5+ boost, which people need to know that we need to get that over to the legendary. So I just made a video on weapon and armor mods. You guys can go check that out if you guys are wondering on how you can get certain mods. It's actually really cool. You can actually utilize your glimmer, and there's a cool farm that you can do for it too. So you guys can check that video out on my channel. But essentially what people are doing to get really, really high, especially only in the first week, is they're not only making three total characters of the same exact type, like warlock, 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 or whatever, but they're then, after they're done with the grind, they'll delete that character or one of them, and then they'll create another one. So they'll essentially create four characters, five characters, six characters to continue the grind over and over again. I don't understand how these people don't sleep, because I've been running on 3 hours of sleep posting videos and grinding, and I only have two characters. Holy God. So yeah, if you guys want to help out, reach out. No, I'm just kidding, but it's crazy. That's exactly how people are doing it. But a very important topic to know, or point to know, I should say. I should have said this earlier in the video, because if anybody clicked out, they're gonna not know this information. So you guys can go ahead and share this video and maybe share this information as well. On your second, third, fourth character, whatever, any character after the first character, your powerful and luminous gear will not scale. It will not scale anymore for this week. It will scale for the following week, but not for this week. And that is something that people were freaking out about. But the thing is, the only thing that can help you after that is exotics. So it still does help, because not only do you still have chances at exotics from public events, nightfalls, random legendary powerful engrams, but also when you do complete those milestones, and let's say Cade or Zavala give you powerful or luminous engrams, you have a chance at an exotic, and that exotic does scale. So keep that in mind, guys. The legendary gear will not scale. The game is not broken. I think Bungie knew that people were going to grind like this, so they kind of wanted to make it somewhat fair. But you still get a ton of exotics on each character. So people just create new characters. They go do the exotic quests, exotic weapons. They do still scale. And then you just want to hope to get exotic gear, but then you'll just infuse that into legendary gear, and then you'll go and get those legendary mods to get those light levels up to get as close to 350 as possible. And I know you guys can get to 350 if any of you guys did want to grind. That is exactly how you do it. So for any of you guys walking around the tower sitting at your 275 280 light, I'm assuming that's around where most people are right now, then you're gonna be like, wait, why is this guy 300 plus light? Why is he 350 light? This is exactly how they do it. I wanted you guys to know so you guys can share this around. Guys, I should have said this earlier as well, but I am going to be giving away a console at 75,000 subscribers, and an even bigger giveaway at 100,000, because that's milestones that I've been wanting to reach on this YouTube career. So if you guys want to subscribe, tell your friends about TKO Gaming, share, connect with us on all of our social media, and then in the link in the description below, you'll have multiple links and multiple outlets to connect with us on all of our social media. You guys want help in trials, raids, whatever, we're also there. Reservations are open. Trials is coming out this coming week. So is a raid. So we want to be there for you guys. We were there all throughout Destiny 1. We helped over 4,000 people in Trials of Osiris go flawless. So we're going to do a lot more here in Destiny 2. Thank you guys so much for the love and support. Every like and comment you guys post, it helps so much. Every notification you guys turn on for you subscribers, it helps so much. And I freaking love you to death. We'll see you guys in the next video. Good luck with all your grinding. Peace out.